Americans disagree about trade. Many on the left and right think we need to protect American jobs by subsidizing US companies to give them an advantage over foreign competition. Meanwhile, other Americans and many economists believe that we benefit from cheaper priced foreign goods and that our savings will help create new jobs in more productive sectors. But no matter which side of that debate you're on, we can all agree on one thing. We'd be crazy to actively subsidize foreign companies to do something cheaper than we could do ourselves. Yet that's exactly what happens with the Universal Postal Union, an agency of the United Nations. The UPU's goal is to ensure mail can be sent from one nation to any other nation in the world. That's a needed service, but there's a problem. Some nations get better rates than others. Specifically,
let's say China.
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 Despite the fact
China
ships more parcels overseas than any other nation in the world, the UPU lists China as a developing nation with a lower rate, which means shipping from China to America costs less than shipping within the United States' own borders. How? China's shipping is subsidized by the American taxpayer through the US Postal Service, which loses billions of dollars every year. Here's an example. Say you want to buy a case for your iPhone. Standard shipping on Amazon for that item from China to New York is $4.99. compared to $5.99 to ship a similar case from Kansas to New York. With little difference in the product, you'll probably opt to save $1 on shipping, but in the long run, the American manufacturer will go out of business because he is unable to compete while the Chinese manufacturer flourishes. Or the American entrepreneur may not even try to compete, knowing it's futile. This harms our manufacturing industry. Meanwhile, you don't actually save the $1 if you're forced to pay it in taxes to cover the US Postal Service's trade deficit. President Trump has decided to pull out of the UPU as part of his trade war with China. However, the formal withdrawal process takes a year, and the White House left open the possibility that the US would remain if it could negotiate a better deal. Meanwhile, China and the other countries who benefit from the lower rates will, no doubt, be lobbying hard to keep them. Whatever you think of trade wars, it's important to understand the need for all international agreements to treat us with equal rates in order to protect both free and fair trade. I'm Jared Cummings. If you liked this video, please help us share it and subscribe to our account. Thanks for watching.